Morning students, today let us start with Lewis dot structure. Before saying this Lewis dot structure, when atoms combine to form the compound, at that time which kind of electrons will take part in the reaction? Valence electrons. So only outermost electrons which is present in the atom, that alone it will involve in bonding. Keep that in your mind, because then only you can understand this Lewis dot structure. Okay, this Lewis dot structure or electron dot symbol, actually it consists of the element which is surrounded by dots. Actually here we kept a dot. Single dot means unpaired electron. When it is having two dots, then it is paired electron. Okay, so what is meant by single bond, single dot? Single dot represents unpaired electron and double dot represents paired electron. Is it clear? Suppose when we are using, apart from dots, when we are using crosses, circles like that, then we can use it for different kinds of atoms. See, that is not given for you. For you, only they gave the symbols. Symbols with its atomic number, electron distribution, and how many valence electrons are there, that how we have to represent. It is given in the form of tabular column. Okay. For hydrogen, we will see first for hydrogen. Hydrogen atomic number is 1. So, electron distribution also only 1. Okay. Valence electron 1. That's why we have represented like this. For 2, it is represented like this. So, here it is unpaired electron. This is paired electron. Clear? Beryllium 4. How we can write this 4? 2, 2. Only these two electron which is present in the valence shell, that will involve in bonding. So, here one single electron, here one single electron. For nitrogen, atomic number is 7. So, what is the electron distribution? 2, 5. Only 5 electrons will involve in chemical bonding. If they are given like that, all the sides should be occupied by one electron. Then only another electron will be paired. Okay. See here, all the 4 sides are occupied by 4 electrons. Then here, one more electron. So, this is paired electron. This remaining 3, it is unpaired electron. Is this clear, ma? I think now you are having idea to write the Lewis dot structures. See, this kind of Lewis dot structures, it will be as just 2 mark or 1 mark like that. Okay. In chemical bonding, already we saw the types of chemical bond. Ionic bond. Ionic bond, how it is formed? It is formed by the transfer of electron from a metal to a non-metal. For that we have see the example sodium chloride. Even magnesium chloride also, same kind of example it is given. That is given in page number 152. Suppose if you are having any doubt, you can ask. See, now in chemical bonding, generally it is of two types. That is, one is strong bond, another one is weak bond. So, all these 4 bonds, it will come under strong bond. Ionic bond, covalent bond, coordinate covalent bond, then metallic bond. Weaker bond means hydrogen bond and van der Waals interaction. It is said to be weaker in nature. Okay. In strong bonds, they gave these 3 bonds in detail. Okay. Ionic bond alone we discussed in last class. Okay. For that only, today also we are going to discuss the properties of ionic bond. First, let us complete the ionic bond. After that, I'll give the explanation for the remaining types of bond. Clear? Now, let us see the properties of ionic bond. Properties, when we are saying, first, physical state. How is the physical state? First of all, ionic bond, how it is formed? It is formed by the electrostatic attraction between cation and anion, Na plus Cl minus. Okay, same manner Mg2 plus 2 chlorine minus. Like that, ionic interaction will be there. So that is strong kind of interaction. Okay, so always it occurs as crystalline solids at room temperature. Is it clear? Electrical conductivity. Electrical conductivity in the sense whether it will conduct the electricity or not. Suppose when ionic compound is present in solid state, it is not having free ions. See, for conducting electricity, two things are needed. One is either it should have free electrons or else it should have free ions. So, free electrons or free ions must be there to conduct electricity. Here the ions are tightly packed. So that is why it doesn't possess free ions. So in solid state, it doesn't conduct electricity. Whereas in molten state means what? When it is dissolved in water, at that time, the ions are free to move so that it will conduct electricity. Is this clear, ma? Next, melting and boiling point. When we are saying about melting and boiling point, already what we said? Ions are held together by strong electrostatic forces of attraction. So bonding will be strong. That is why it requires high amount of heat for splitting. So obviously, this ionic compounds possess high melting as well as high boiling point. Is it clear? Next, solubility. When we are saying about solubility, generally these ionic compounds are soluble in polar solvents. For polar solvents, best example is water. Whereas it is insoluble in non-polar solvents. For non-polar solvents, we can give so many examples. Even in your textbook, benzene, carbon tetrachloride. See, its formula also given. For benzene, formula is C6H6 and carbon tetrachloride, it is CCl4. Even you should know that formula. Okay. So, ionic compounds are generally soluble in polar solvents and insoluble in non-polar solvents. Density, hardness and brittleness. Generally, as it is tightly packed, obviously this ionic compounds possess high density. Moreover, it is hard in nature. Brittleness means what? It can be broken down into pieces. It is highly brittle in nature. Okay. Reactions. Final property is reactions. Ionic compounds generally it undergoes ionic reactions. So reactions will be rapid. Rapid in the sense quick. Quick and instantaneous. So what are the properties of ionic compound? Physical state, electrical conductivity, melting and boiling point, solubility, density, hardness and brittleness, and reactions. So with this, we'll complete today's class, students. In next class, we'll discuss covalent bond in detail. Okay. See, suppose if you are having any doubt in the formation of ionic bond in magnesium chloride, you can ask in Google Meet. Thank you, students.